Hello students, how are you all? Hope you are doing good. Today we are going to discuss about the topic job restructuring from the second unit. So here, what do you mean by job restructuring, ma'am? The changes which will happen in your job, the changes which will change the structure of the existing job by adding some tasks, by adding some responsibility, by adding some activities or eliminating some unnecessary activities from the job which we are doing at present. Why this job restructuring will be happening means now, it is the beneficial factor for the organization. How means some activities are to be performed, some tasks should be performed within the time which is necessary for the organization to be performed in the market. So at that time, they require an employee to perform the additional task, the additional performance, and also the additional role and responsibility to be taken to reach the targets of the organization. That's why the job restructuring will be done here. How this restructuring will be done here means, ma'am, the restructuring will be done in the horizontal way and as well as in a vertical format. How this horizontal way means, ma'am, already the existing job of the expansion of adding the tasks and the duties and also the performance to be done in the existing job. And what do you mean by the vertical job restructuring? In this vertical job restructuring, the role and the responsibility will be added, and also you need to be complete the previous task in a higher level. So what it is, ma'am? We have a two, that is the horizontal job restructuring and the vertical job restructuring. In the horizontal job restructuring, we may expand the current job by adding the activities, by adding the tasks, by adding the performance level in current doing job at the same level of the job. And whereas in a vertical means adding of the role, adding of responsibility, and also completion of the previous task in a higher level. That is about the job restructuring. And what this includes, what job restructuring is being included? The first point is for company reorganization. So here, the first point which is included in the job restructuring is the company reorganization. Already the changes which is going to happen in the existing organization, the changes which is happened in the existing structure, and here, mom, and the job restructuring may be the part of the broadening of the company reorganization. How? In the case of by eliminating the people who are unnecessary, and by eliminating the department, and by eliminating the activities within the organization. Why this will be happening? Why means in some cases, when the organization will fall into the losses, they require only the quality people. Why? Because when they fall into the loss means the capable to feed the employee will be a less. So that's why they eliminate the unnecessary employees, they eliminate unnecessary activities, they eliminate the unnecessary department. But by eliminating all these activities, one advantage will be there and one disadvantage will be there. The advantage is, ma, they may save some amount, and the disadvantage is the work which has to be done by the eliminated person will be on the present existing person. That burden will be on the employees. With that burden, the employees may feel unsatisfied and they may feel a lack of interest also on the work which they are supposed to do. Why? Because if they have huge burden, huge work to do on the head means they may not keep their 100% in the work to be completed, as they having heavy work to do, as they having a pressure to do the work. So in this way, the employee may be unsatisfied and he may not give his 100%, and this will directly influence on the organization. So not to happen that at the time of company reorganization, they have to think that they need to take a certain safety measures that not to affect on the employee. It may not lead to employee unsatisfaction. So while doing the company reorganizing also, they need to take some precautions. They need to take some safety measurements that may not affect on the employees. And next point is now reasonable accommodation. So here, a common reason companies restructure job is to meet the requirements to make a reasonable accommodation for the disabled workers here. What is the main reason? What is one of the reason for the job restructuring is to meet the reasonable accommodation for the disabled people here. They want in every organization, whether the private or the public, there will be on a certain reservation for the physically disabled people. So in that aspect, the organization will be thinking that whether we are going to meet this point by providing an employment opportunity to the physically disabled people where they can sit and work, by providing a job that they can perform well by sitting in a one desk and doing the system work. The system work will be an easier for them to do. Why? Because there won't be any movement of moving from here to there and going and giving a meeting in another country or giving a performance in another branch. So in this way, the physically disabled people will be suffering. So not to suffer in that aspect, the company will seek that certain reasonable accommodation means the work which the physically disabled people can perform, like system work, calling of someone, giving information, taking the information, where they are going to sit in a one place and do. So this point, whether the organization is meeting this point, they will be seeking that in the job restructuring. And also reasonable accommodation, as we are going to add some tasks, some activities, some performance to the employees, definitely that employees may expect something return in from the organization, as in the format of hike, as in the format of bonus, as in the format of promotion. So the organization also think that whether we are meeting the reasonable accommodation where the employees is expecting from the organization. So that is the reasonable accommodation. This thing will happen during the job restructuring. The next one is employee satisfaction. So here in employee satisfaction, we have discussed the previous of job rotation. Why the job rotation will be done? It will be done to decrease the burden of the employee and increase the interest of the employee, and they can improve the skill and knowledge. And if they are increasing the interest means ma, what will happen automatically, the satisfaction will be there towards the work. So the same will happen here, job restructuring. As the job restructuring may add task, may add the performance, may add the activities, may add the role and responsibility, the existing person, the existing employee, as he was changing from one to another, as he was adding another new work, he may feel interested to work towards the work. When he was feeling interested to work towards the work means definitely the employee may get a satisfaction. Unless if he is doing the routine work. So ఏంటిదంటే మా రొటీన్ వర్క్ చేసే బదులు కొత్త టాస్క్, కొత్త పర్ఫార్మెన్స్, కొత్త యాక్టివిటీస్ ఒక జాబ్లో ఇంక్లూడ్ అయినట్లయితే ఆటోమేటిక్గా మనకి ఇంట్రెస్ట్ అనేది పెరిగిపోతుంది. ఇంట్రెస్ట్ పెరిగిపోతే మనకి సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్ అనేది మిగుతుంది. సో హియర్ విత్ ద జాబ్ రీస్ట్రక్చరింగ్ యాజ్ ద ఆల్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ యాడింగ్ అండ్ ఎక్స్పాండింగ్ డెఫినెట్లీ ద ఎంప్లాయీ విల్ బి ఫీలింగ్ ఇంట్రెస్టెడ్ టు వర్క్ టు ద న్యూ వర్క్ విచ్ ఇస్ అసైన్డ్ బై ద ఆర్గనైజేషన్. ఇఫ్ హీ ఫీల్స్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ మీన్స్ డెఫినెట్లీ ద సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్ విల్ బి గెయిన్డ్ బై ద ఎంప్లాయీ హియర్. సో దట్స్ వై వీ కెన్ సేస్ దట్ జాబ్ రిస్ట్రక్చరింగ్ విల్ ఆల్సో విల్ ఎన్హాన్స్ ద ఎంప్లాయీ సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్. అండ్ ద లాస్ట్ పాయింట్ ఇన్ ద జాబ్ రిస్ట్రక్చరింగ్ ఈస్ మా ద ఫోర్త్ పాయింట్ ప్రోస్ అండ్ కాన్స్. Pros and cons. What do you mean by pros and cons means ma? In job restructuring, as we are making an employee to accept another role and another responsibility to take it, so in this format we are making an employee to take another role which is current available and current necessary. For example, ma, let me give you one example. As I was appointed in one organization in the year 2000. So here, if I am doing continuously that role which I have been given in the year 2000, I will not be able to compete with the current situation. Why? Because my mind will be there in the 2000, not come to 2020. So if that thing happened continuously in the organization, what will be happen? An employee may not be competent with the other employee, and he may not give his a good, he may not be advantageous to the organization. And in this aspect, this will be a disadvantage for the organization and with the organization. So here, not to happen all these things, they may keep this job restructuring by taking a new role, by taking a new responsibility. With this taking of new responsibility and new role, the employee may be like will be having the advanced technology, the current, he may go with the current situation, he may be adopting the new technology and new knowledge. So with this, what will happen means he will be able to give a good competition to the present situation. So here the pros and cons will make an employee to take up a new responsibility and new role where it is required for the current situation, and this also will be an advantageous for the organization. So in job restructuring, what we have now, we have elements called four. The first one is job reorganizing. In the job company reorganizing, what will be happening means we will be eliminating some department, some unnecessary activities, some unnecessary staff also. Why? Because if during the last time to save some amount here, and also while doing this we need to, the company also need to take some measures. And next one is ma, reasonable accommodation for disabled, physically disabled people. The company has to give certain employment opportunity, and as well as we are giving certain role and responsibility additionally to the employees, if they are going to complete that, they may definitely expect something in return from the organization in the format of the hike, or in the format of incentives, in the format of salary, in the format of promotion, etc. So we need to also be, the organization also need to meet the necessary elements of the employee. And next one is my employee satisfaction. As they were adopting the new role and new responsibility and task also, the employee will be feeling satisfied with the words. And next one is my pros and cons. We are making an employee to adopt and to take up a new role and responsibility which is necessary for the current situation. This is about today's class, job restructuring.